If you find it shocking that the richest man in Asia made his billions selling bottled water, you're not alone. As of September 2021, Zhang Shanshan has a net worth of $64.5 billion. I don't even want to imagine how many bottles of water he had to sell to make that much money. What makes me curious is how he made billions of dollars in an industry that is so saturated. Welcome to Luxury Rewind. In today's video, we will be looking at Zhang Shanshan's story to understand how he made his billions. Without wasting any more time, let's get right into it. Shanshan's success is more significant than it might appear on paper. Zhang Shanshan was able to become Asia's richest person just by selling water, and he achieved this without the backing of old money, family influence, or any of the advantages that most of the world's richest had. In 1954, Zhang Shanshan was born in Hangzhou, China. By the age of 12, Zhang was forced to drop out of school due to the chaos during what is now referred to as the Great Proletarian Cultural Revolution. The economic instability that followed the political crisis meant that Zhang had to quickly become useful to his family. Due to his age and education level, Zhang had limited employment options. This forced him to take up odd jobs to help support his family, the most notable of these jobs being his time spent as a construction worker. In 1977, Zhang continued his education by enrolling at the Zhejiang Radio and TV University to study Chinese. After graduating, he got a job as a journalist at the Zhejiang Daily, though he didn't spend too long working there. Zhang impulsively quit his job at Zhejiang Daily and moved to Hainan to launch a business for reasons we are not sure of. At Hainan Island, Zhang started a business selling mushrooms, turtles, and prawns. It seems the company was not successful. Either that, or Zhang was dissatisfied with it. Whatever the case, Zhang shut down the business and took up a job at the Wahaha Beverage Company. Here, he took up the role of a sales agent, focusing on the sales of healthcare supplements. This period was significant in Zhang's life because it was during the period he spent working at the Wahaha Beverage Company that he got the idea to start a bottled water company. Once again, Zhang took the risk and left his job to open what became known as the Nongfu Spring Company. But this doesn't explain why Nongfu Spring is so successful. How did a startup in such a competitive industry manage to find so much success? Well, Zhang did something very different from other companies, which was to stop removing the natural minerals from the bottled water. It is not immediately apparent that this simple decision would spark such tremendous success, especially since the Chinese people didn't seem to mind drinking distilled water. However, due to the growing pollution of natural water sources in China, public awareness about the importance of minerals in water and their health benefits began to grow rapidly. This is when Zhang decided to strike. Call it luck, but Zhang's timing and competent use of this opportunity made Nongfu Spring the ideal choice for the masses. This is incredible, since Nongfu Spring was one of the thousands of bottled water companies in China at the time. They even managed to compete with and overtake industry bullies like Coca-Cola and Pepsi, which owns some of the most popular bottled water brands in the world. Like all self-made billionaires, Zhang had to work extremely hard to gain his wealth. Though his focus and dedication was exemplary, it was his understanding of the market and insatiable quest to create more value for his customers that took Nongfu Spring to the top of the industry. Nongfu Spring would eventually find success outside China as well. The company's consistent innovation and impressive distribution chain soon led to the incredible amounts of annual revenue that placed it in the global spotlight. For example, in 2019, Nongfu Spring generated a grand revenue of around $3.4 billion. The company also branched into the production of other types of beverages, such as fruit and various types of juices, teas, and even coffee, which is produced under its Tanbing brand. The company has stayed at the top of China's beverage market for nearly a decade, beating popular beverages such as Coca-Cola. Even with the success of Nongfu Spring, Zhang Shanshan has not shown any sign of slowing down. It seems that his success is only going to increase over the years. After all, Zhang only made it to the Billionaires Club in the year 2020 due to the success of Nongfu Spring and his other company, the Beijing Wantai Biological Pharmacy. The Beijing Wantai Biological Pharmacy found immense success during the height of the COVID-19 pandemic. Once the company began to develop a nasal spray COVID-19 vaccine, its shares have increased by 2,000%. Currently, Zhang still owns about 85% of Nongfu Spring and 75% of Wantai Pharmacy. During the peak of his recent success, Zhang was able to beat out successful competitors such as the multi-billionaire founder and owner of Alibaba, Jack Ma. He defeated them and was crowned the richest man in Asia as soon as his net worth crossed the $80 billion mark. Soon after, Zhang Shanshan's status as the richest Asian man was cemented when his net worth hit a mind-blowing $94 billion. He became the sixth richest person on the planet, behind personalities like Mark Zuckerberg, Bernard Arnault, Bill Gates, Jeff Bezos, and Elon Musk. Although his net worth has reduced significantly, it is still an impressive number, especially because of the product he sells. If you were to make a list of products that could potentially make you a billionaire, bottled water will probably not make that list. However, Zhang Shanshan has proven that with drive, focus, and the right amount of innovation, you could be years away from your first billion. That brings us to the end of today's video. If you found this video valuable, kindly hit the subscribe and notification buttons so you won't miss out on any new videos. Thanks for watching.